Hello, everyone, and welcome back. The first movie that I want to talk about is Sometimes, Always, Never. Not to be confused with Never, Rarely, Sometimes, Always, which I also saw this year and really enjoyed. Sometimes, Always, Never was directed by Carl Hunter and was written by
Frank Cottrell Boyce.
The film was actually released at a London film festival back in 2018 and didn't find its way to the US until Cinequest Film Festival in 2019. But then it didn't get a wide release until June of this year, almost 2 years after the original release. But I'm still considering it a 2020 film. Sometimes Always Never tells the story of a father searching for his son who disappeared after a game of Scrabble. He becomes so obsessed with the search that, well, I'm sure you can guess. I really liked the style of this movie. It gave me a Wes Anderson vibe sometimes. The cinematography, set design, and score were all fantastic and very stylish. I really enjoyed the performances and themes. It knows when to be funny and to be serious, and I thoroughly enjoyed all of the characters. It's a great heartwarming family movie that I think most people will enjoy. And I'm giving Sometimes Always Never a 7 out of 10. Next, I watched The Old Guard, directed by
Gina Prince-Bythewood
and written by Greg Rucka. The film is about a group of immortals who have been around since, like, before Jesus, I guess. One day, a mission goes wrong and they are all exposed and must now fight to keep their identity a secret just as an unexpected new member is discovered. Man, I really did not have a good time watching this movie. The music, the dialogue, and editing are just awful. The antagonist is extremely boring and generic. The writing was also boring, and I just didn't care about any of the characters. So, all of these people are immortal, I guess. But they never really explain the details. Do they get hungry? Thirsty? In The Curse of the Black Pearl, they give us plenty of details on how their immortality works. But in The Old Guard, they just say, yeah, we can live forever, but at some random point, the powers will just go away and we will die for real. And that's it. And it just forces me to say, okay, well, what about this? They do explain how they discover a new immortal, but it really makes no sense. Honestly, the only thing I liked was the ending. And I'm giving The Old Guard a 3 out of 10. Next, I watched Enola Holmes on Netflix. It's directed by Harry Bradbeer and written by Jack Thorne. And it's about Enola Holmes, the younger sister of Sherlock and Mycroft. Enola develops a very close relationship with her mother, who one day disappears. Enola decides to take things into her own hands and set off to find her. This is another movie that I thought was fine. I honestly have no desire to see it again. All of the performances are fantastic. Henry Cavill stood out the most to me as Sherlock, but I mean, the writing was kind of shit. I hated Enola's fourth wall breaking and most of the dialogue. Although I did enjoy the twists, the music was fine, I guess. But the thing that stood out to me the most was the cinematography. Holy shit, the cinematography was insane. Nearly every shot was just gorgeous. Overall, I think this would make for a great family movie night. The themes are cute and the film is funny and colorful, despite a few very dark moments. And I'm giving Enola Holmes a 7 out of 10. Finally, I actually went to a movie theater and watched Tenet. Yes, the new Christopher Nolan movie. Holy shit. I don't even know what I thought of this movie. I was so goddamn confused the entire time. It got to a point where I just sat there, turned my brain off, and just watched the crazy shit happening on the screen. In hindsight, I should have just left. I mean, I have the Regal Unlimited subscription, so it didn't cost me anything to see this movie. So I would have lost nothing by leaving. Don't even ask me what this movie was about, because I honestly don't know. The writing was not good. I already mentioned I was confused, and it really didn't help that the pacing was so incredibly fast, especially in the beginning. Apparently, the protagonist of the movie is just named protagonist. What? One of the big side effects of rapid pacing is that I don't get any time to connect with the characters. And if I don't connect with the characters, why should I care about any of them? The performances were all bad. Fucking Kenneth Branagh mumbles the entire time. And I mean, I just hated the dialogue, just in general. I did not have a good time watching this. Probably because I had no idea what the fuck was even happening. Also, the movie is just a different look at time travel. Don't listen to what these retards in the movie have to say. It's fucking time travel. And if you've watched my previous videos, you know how I feel about fucking time travel. If I do watch this again, it'll be in my bedroom and I'll have subtitles on. I can appreciate what Nolan is trying to do, but this is far from his best. And I'm giving Tenet the shrug emoji. It was better than Dunkirk.